And if you're able to share a little bit, kind of, when I went to your event, you had this up on something similar like this up on the board at one point when you were teaching. And this is in one of your books as well. It's going from thought to energy to matter. And can you explain a little bit more about what this is? I'm gonna have it up on the screen for people to see it when you're talking about it, but there's different frequencies.
Yeah, I read a physics book where this physics professor was talking about the fertile void, the vacuum energy. And he said that the vacuum energy, number one, the void, was pure consciousness. Mm-hmm. I remember reading that and throwing the book down and saying, what is pure consciousness? I had to really think about it. Pure consciousness is a consciousness that is conscious of everybody, every body, everyone, everything, everywhere, and every time, past, present, and future. So this is that kind of unified field, this universal mind. And at the top is a straight line, and that straight line represents a frequency that is absolute speed, the fastest frequency, and absolute rest in a non-vibrating state, right? Mm-hmm.
Zero vibration,
so fast. The wave is so fast that the point of absolute speed and point of absolute rest merge. And now you're everywhere all at once. You can't go anywhere because you're everywhere, right? So it's a kind of a crazy concept, okay? He said it was pure consciousness. And he said in it lies all potential realities in their non-manifest, immaterial, intangible form. And he said in order for matter to appear in this void, in this vacuum, a vibratory sensation must be set into motion in the void. And what's a vibration in the quantum? A thought. It's a disturbance, right? Mm. All right, so look at that flat line. If you start lowering frequencies down, you keep lowering frequencies down, you get to this the lowest frequency down here, and that lowest frequency down here at the very bottom is called matter. Mm. The slowest frequency that we perceive with our senses. So every single person, every soul has come from source, from singularity, from oneness, from wholeness, and we descended all the way down into density, into three-dimensional reality, fooled by our senses that this is the only reality there is. And so much of our attention is on our bodies, on the people in our life, on the things we own, and the places we live, the places we need to be, the places we need to go, and time itself, that we create this identity that's identifying with three-dimensional reality, and we have no awareness of where we've come from. Throw in the hormones of stress and activate the senses, and now you're really your body, now you're really your environment, that's where all your attention is, you're really obsessed with time, and now you gotta play by the rules of Newtonian physics, and now everything is predictable, everything is known, everything you gotta plan to make happen in three-dimensional reality. So then vibration, think of a pendulum. Take a pendulum, you got that point at the top, and swing a pendulum, and anything that vibrates, anything that oscillates, moves between two points of rest, two poles. And at the point where it goes at one point and it stops, that is the point of absolute rest, that is no time. At the point where it's at the very bottom, right straight down, perpendicular, vertical, that point right there is when it's moving at its absolute speed. Mm. Then it's gotta go uphill, and then it stops, and now you're at a point of absolute rest. So this oscillation that's created is called a frequency, right? And if you were to measure that mathematically, it's a sine wave. And at the very top of, say, the sine wave, the peak, that's the point of absolute rest. Mm-hmm. As it moves down and it's moving down, that right in the middle is the point of absolute speed, and then it goes to the point of absolute rest. Now, absolute rest is no time. Source energy, there's no space and there's no time. There's no separation. So then the slowest frequency then, in that point where it starts oscillating, you can see the slower frequencies are touching source a lot less. As the frequencies get faster, as the points of absolute speed and the points of absolute rest get closer and closer together, you're touching source more because you're touching no time more.
Interesting.
So now you feel more whole, you feel more love, you feel more freedom, you feel more faster frequencies, more bliss, more wholeness because there's less separation.
Interesting.
So now the fastest frequencies, Planck constant, The frequency is so fast, take a centimeter of this frequency and there's enough energy to create the entire universe.
Wow.
That's how much energy is in there, okay?
Wow.
So you get to a point where the points of absolute speed and the points of absolute rest merge. That point, that non-vibratory state, has an infinite number of potentials, an enormous amount of power. It is the source of everything physical and material, right? So then energy slows down, and as it slows down, it has its own characteristics, and it reaches a point where it can no longer be whole. When it reaches a point where it no longer can be whole, it divides. It separates, it bursts, mm-hmm. and now you have light and photons and electrons and positive charge and negative charge and past and future and sound, and the frequency slows all the way down into density, right? So then our job then is to take all of our attention off our body, off our environment and time, and really move to a place where we're conscious of nothing but you as an awareness.
Mm-hmm.
And when you do that, that point of where you become pure consciousness is the door to the quantum field.
Wow.
That's where we start interacting with different energies and frequencies. So we use this model to help people understand that the closer you get to source, if you're vibrating at this frequency as pure consciousness and you're creating from here, there's less separation between you as your individual consciousness and oneness. If there's less separation between two points of consciousness and you're creating from the field, it should appear in three-dimensional reality in a shorter amount of time. Down here, there's a lot of separation. It's just going to take you a long time
to
create what you want, right? So getting beyond yourself and becoming pure consciousness, there's a whole unlearning process that has to go on. Why? Because we're still programmed to believe when we're in that void or in that vacuum, in that nothing, in the emptiness, we actually believe there's Lewis or Joe Dispenza, I'm here, and then there's the vacuum and the void here, and you still believe you're separate. And that is a whole unlearning process that has to go on to realize that you're a thought, you're an awareness there. And in that state, if you're truly there, aware of nothing but you, and if you're creating from that place, your thought actually produces a frequency. And if you can feel the frequency of the thought, in other words, the thought of your abundance in the 5D reality produces the feeling of abundance,
yes,
of worthiness. Your thought of your wealth in three-dimensional reality produces the feeling of lack of not having it. So when we create from the field, we have to create from the state where we feel the feeling of the event before it occurs. In the quantum, you have to feel it first to experience it in three-dimensional reality. So change the information, wow, in the field, you change the hologram. This is all a hologram. You're gonna change the projection in three-dimensional reality. So we teach people how to practice with brain and heart coherence to change more information in the field, keep changing the information in the field, get closer and closer to source. This is the greater mind. You don't have to worry about when it's gonna happen or how it's gonna happen or try to predict it. It's none of your business.
Right. And you already feel good too.
Yeah, you're creating from wholeness.
Right.
You're creating from wholeness instead of from lack. And so when you start synchronizing your energy in the proper way and you keep inputting into the field, then you start seeing the synchronicities in your life. You know, I'm not talking about a parking space.
Yeah.
I'm talking about like opportunities, like in your life.
Yeah.
Well, whatever I just did this morning, I'm going back tomorrow, I'm doing it again, because I believe now that I'm the creator, and that is what actually enhances the outcome, right? So people in this work, they do the work because they don't want the magic to end, right? Experimenting, creating from the field instead of from matter to shorten the distance, the time, between the thought of what you want and the experience of having it when we create from the field instead of from matter. And so you gotta get to the field first. And you gotta get to the field and you can't go as a somebody.
Yeah.
You gotta go as a nobody. And I think I've labored for years to get people to get beyond themselves. And that's the work. You know, that's really the work.